When India beat Australia in Australia after 71 years, a few Indian cricketers made headlines. Bumrah and Shami for taking match-winning spells, Pujara and Virat for scoring match-winning runs. But two players got into trouble for scoring. For his comments on coffee with Karan, Hardik Pandya in particular was called a sexist and a male chauvinist pig, having an old-fashioned attitude towards women. Is it a justified allegation?
When I lost my virginity, I came home and said to my parents, "Today I did it."
One day at a party, his father asked him,
"Hardik, which one is your girl?"
"All of them."
While he may have been a bit crude about the way he said it, we think a modern India can do with openness, honesty and trust between parents and children instead of
"My parents just don't understand me."
Kiss and tell was wrong on Pandya's part, and he should never have publicly revealed the name of the woman he had an affair with. Former India captain and batting maestro Sunil Gavaskar praised the BCCI for suspending Pandya and Rahul.
"If you do things that bring your team and game into disrepute, then you can't be part of the team."
How wrong the great Sunil Gavaskar is. Bringing the game into disrepute is when you break the laws of the game, like ball tampering, see Bisbo's story. Or cheating, like match or spot fixing, see Bisbo's story on both these topics. Or getting a nick and being caught behind, but not walking. Or taking a catch off the bounce. Pandya and Rahul did none of these things. If they got anyone into disrepute, it's themselves. And they paid the price. Pandya lost his endorsement deal with Gillette, valued at approximately 2 crore or $350,000. The next accusation against Pandya especially is that he made racist remarks.
"What is the first thing that attracts you to a girl? I'm a little from the black side, so I have to see how they move first."
Racism would be what Pakistan captain Sarfraz Ahmed said to the coloured South African and in Felekwayo in January 2019. For which the Pakistani was handed a 4-match ban. If anything, their talk was loose and disrespectful, which both got a sense of later.
"I would like to apologize to everyone. Honestly, I got a bit carried away with the nature of the show."
The team largely supported the duo, and skipper Virat Kohli made a mildly condemnatory remark.
"We as the Indian cricket team and responsible cricketers don't align with those views. Those were individual opinions."
Ravi Shastri, never one to mince words, supported the duo completely.
"They are just kids having fun. Don't spoil their careers."
Even Hardik Pandya's father Himanshu jumped to defend his son.
"He was only looking to entertain the audience. He has a fun-loving nature."
But the powers of the Committee of Administrators, CoA, appointed by the Supreme Court to oversee cricket, harshly suspended them under Rule 41. This overreaction was also the result of various subplots going on within competing authorities. Subplot number 1. Constant sparring between BCCI and CoA. BCCI's Rahul Johri believes
players should be allowed to play until inquiry is completed.
COA's Vinod Rai, on the other hand,
they should be suspended for 2 matches immediately.
Subplot number 2. Infighting between the two COAs.
We need a quick inquiry.
We don't want any cover-up like the Rahul Johri Me Too case.
Subplot number 3. COA Dina Dalji's personal distrust towards BCCI chief Rahul Johri.
Preliminary inquiry should be handled by BCCI.
Inquiry should be handled by the Supreme Court appointed ombudsman.
An ombudsman is a person especially appointed to deal with complaints, acts of indiscipline or misconduct, and is supposed to be a retired judge of either the Supreme Court or High Court. The players were suspended on January 11th, but the previous ombudsman, Ajit Prakash Shah, had already retired in November, while the new one, P.S. Narasimha, was due to be appointed only in February. The duo were left with no one to appeal to. Surprisingly, the colourful Harbhajan Singh added more fuel to the fire.
Hardik tried to look cool on TV and made people think that Anil Kumble or Sachin Tendulkar were also like them. But we are not like them.
Meanwhile, all this was having a negative effect on the team balance and morale. Who sent a message?
"Send Hardik Pandya to join the team in New Zealand the moment the ban is lifted."
2 weeks later on Jan 24th, Edalji finally relented and agreed to lift the suspension, allowing Pandya to join his team for the remaining ODI series. it is likely that the ombudsman will use the broad umbrella of the contract terms to penalize them further. Contracted players of BCCI are specifically banned from participating in unapproved tournaments, organizing foreign tours, or doing acts that harm the interests of the game or of the board. Rahul Dravid is probably the only person who has been able to spot the silver lining in this ugly incident and turn it into a positive for the players.
I have coached both of them and know they are yet to achieve their potential. This incident might be the catalyst.
However, an equally serious case has been given much more leeway. Women's team all-rounder Harmanpreet Kaur continues to represent India while under investigation even after her graduation degrees were found to be fake. For Karan Johar, this was the first time any current cricketer came on his chat show and now will probably be the last.
I feel responsible because it was my show. I have had so many sleepless nights thinking how to undo this damage.
This incident has taught all sportsmen the standards expected of them in public life. The youth look up to them as a role model more than to film stars, and that is really good to know. Bisbo's limerick. Hardik and KL made some cheesy comments. There was little left to say in their defense. But the COA overreacted and an apology extracted. Though the harm their infighting can cause cricket can be immense. Subscribe to Bisbo's channel and be sure to click on the bell icon. Be the first to know when Bisbo releases a new video.